Gu Yuxuan had a difficult relationship with his father as a child. He drank and often quarreled, and only a neighbor girl, Han Shuyan, was able to support him in his difficult situation. When he was playing in the yard near the house, the girl came over to ask him what he was playing. It turned out that it was his birthday and he was making a big cake. Han Shuyan reminded him that he had to light a candle and make a wish. She gave him a toy goose for the holiday. Yuxuan said that when he was born, it was the first snow, and his mother said that with the first snow, people we care about come. The children went for a walk, and the first snowflakes began to fly, and it was the first snow that brought Shuyan to Yuxuan. Later she moved to another city, the guy prayed to God to meet her again. The wedding of young Teddy and Olivia, a solemn celebration, many guests gathered, but someone damaged a huge birthday cake. Yuxuan and a girl who reminded him a lot of Shuyan asked him to help him save the cake, because soon there will be a solemn cake cutting for the guests. Of course, he agreed and helped. Then, at the party, all the guests received boxes with gifts, and what did the girl want to get? A cat with a time machine, but she got a cat on a flying saucer. After the wedding, he decided to walk the girl home. On the way, they saw a toy vending machine, and Yuxuan offered his girlfriend to pull out a cat with a time machine, and it turned out that his company makes these gift figures in boxes, and he could bring her from work the toy she wanted. The girl refused because it's not the same as pulling out a gift for good luck. If fate is against it, she won't insist on it. They got to the bus stop, the bus came, she had to go, and the guy decided to jump on the bus after her. She got this cat on a flying saucer again, he must be chasing her. He pulled out another box with a toy for her, drew her a goose, and said that this one would definitely bring her good luck. After a while they went to eat delicious desserts, lemon cake from Peter. It really was Shuyan, he didn't expect to see her again someday, he felt lucky. How did it happen that he makes toys? It all started with that birthday when she gave him a goose, and he seems to be surrounded by these toys, and every day he feels calm and happy about gifts and holidays. Shuyan used to bake cakes to order, and she always dreamed of opening her own bakery and making the most delicious cakes and desserts in the world. Yuxuan assured her that if such a bakery opened, there would be a line of customers, as he had eaten a huge number of cakes in his life, and the ones Shuyan made were the most delicious. They started dating, having fun together. Yuxuan no longer wanted to be just her friend, and the couple got together. They were together all the time. They always had something to talk about. Her cake won the best dessert competition and was published in a magazine, and he created a new collection of figurines in her honor. Sometimes they quarreled, sometimes they loved, but they lived together wonderfully, and everything was as good as it was once. Sad news, his father died. Some people came to the funeral and said that his father owed them money, the debt was now transferred to him, and he had to pay a lot of money. Yuxuan immersed himself in his work and did not notice how time and energy were running out. One day, these people came to the office where he was working, and he had to do something about it. New Year's Eve a month later, in the morning as usual, Yuxuan dropped Shuyan off with packages of orders to his co-worker's friend Olivia, a blogger, and they put the cakes on plates and took pictures of the beauty to show everyone. Olivia introduced Shuyan as a pastry chef, and if anyone wants such desserts, you can place an order. Yuxuan was late for an important meeting with Bai Chu about the design of new figures. A new contract had to be signed, but he had no time to do anything. Shuyan had been fiddling with packages for a long time that morning. A traffic jam on the way to the place where the meeting was scheduled. Bai Chu could not wait so long, Yuxuan could not get there, and time was running out. It seemed that a little more time and Bai Chu would have left, but in the last minutes the contract was signed. The deal was successful. Everything went as planned. Here his friend and colleague shows him the work of a master. His drawings are very similar to those of Yuxuan. He thinks they should get acquainted. Maybe in the future they will work together. The designer Yuxuan thinks that his colleague is right and decides to go to see the artist. He turned out to be an old man who started speaking in strange phrases, but he said that it was possible to go back to the beginning of history, but sometimes it was very difficult to do something differently. The protagonist in his project is ready to give everything to change the future. Yuxuan notes that the idea of the story is clear, but the ending is unclear. How does the hero find a way out of this situation? The old master replies that there is no ending, that he is still returning to the beginning of the story. Moreover, even though he sent his project to his company, he wants to talk to someone who understands what the story is really about and get to the bottom of it. Perhaps what was to happen was already predestined by fate. It's time for the New Year's holiday, Yuxuan's birthday, and the boss of their company wants to congratulate all the employees and invites them to a festive corporate party in honor of the new year and the successful completion of the year. It will be a party in costumes in the style of the fairy tale Alice in the Emerald City, and everyone who comes will receive red envelopes with gifts. Yuk Swan tries to ask his boss to leave early to celebrate his birthday with his girlfriend, but the boss won't let him go, saying that he will have time to be with the girl, and the party is today, and he is in charge of the project he signed with Bai Chu, so he can't miss the party and has to stay. Xu Yan comes to the party. She received a call from a collection company. It turned out that her boyfriend owes a lot of money. She is worried. She asked him to explain everything that happened. He rudely replies that it's his business and he'll handle everything himself. First of all, they can't pay off the debts they saved for the bakery, and if he gives away everything he has, he won't be able to have a lavish wedding for them, won't be able to buy their dream house and make their lives beautiful. Xu Yan asks if he doesn't believe in them at all. Yuk Swan is disappointed. He doesn't even believe in himself. His beloved is in despair. She cannot accept that he could leave her so easily. She turns around and leaves. He runs after her. A car is driving down the street. It hits the scaffolding that has been built for fixite work. It falls on Xu Yan. The rescuers pull out her body. The ambulance takes her to the hospital, but she dies. The next day, Yuk Swan wakes up, goes to the kitchen and sees his beloved, who is diligently putting the orders in packages. He runs up and hugs her, realizes that it is the same day as his birthday. He takes her to Olivia's place, then goes to sign the contract, then back to the master. Does he know anything about this? The old man replies, "Don't you think you have all of eternity to make love? Master, do you think Xu Yan will die anyway? The only thing he can do is use the time they have left differently." He doesn't believe the master. He thinks there must be a way to save her. Then he goes back to Olivia's to pick her up. Picks up Xu Yan and mentions that she's been wanting to take him out for a while. She suggests they go see this great place that's perfect for her future bakery. They go there. The house is old. The cafe is abandoned. They will have to put a lot of effort into fixing it up, and part of the money they have saved will go to renovate the place. Suddenly, a lantern falls and breaks, but does not hurt Xu Yan, as if everything is fine, and they return to the car. In the parking lot, they see the father beating the boy. Yuk Swan, of course, intervenes, a quarrel breaks out, a push and shove ensues, he hits the father, the girl stops him, the police arrive and take him away until all the reasons for the fight are clarified and an investigation is conducted. The police advise you to cooperate with them and then you will be able to find the truth. The parking lot cameras show how the man physically assaulted his son. Yuk Swan was defending the kid, so he is acquitted and released. Yuk Swan leaves the police station, calls his beloved, but the number is out of service. After a while, he receives an urgent call. His number is listed as an emergency number in case something happens. Xu Yan has an accident and needs to go to the hospital. He again fails to save her, and she dies again. Yuk Swan goes to the master again. He needs to know who he is. It turns out that it is him, just many years later, old and living alone all his life because he could not change anything. It is worth remembering that he can only use the time he has left and cherish every moment. Yuk Swan goes home, takes out a cake, lights the candle again, makes a wish for Xu Yan to come back to him, and he will do anything for this. And the third day comes, his beloved is back in the kitchen, making cakes again, and Yuk Swan suggests that she stay home, as if he had taken the day off. He goes with her to Olivia's to pick up the cakes, calls his friend Teddy to make the deal with Bai Chu himself, meets him later, and has an important conversation about the future. Then he returns to Olivia's to pick up Xu Yan, and thinks that he should go to her mom and confess that she is not an English teacher but a pastry chef. Mom is very angry. She lied about being a teacher and quietly became a pastry chef, but Yuk Swan asked her to listen to Xu Yan, because she has never eaten her cakes. Why does she think they are not good? She loves what she does with all her heart, and when she sees people eating her desserts and being happy, she sees it and is happy with them. Xu Yan's mother loves strawberries, so her daughter cooked a cake with strawberries for her. Her mother tasted a piece. It was really delicious and forgave her for everything. It turns out that confessing is not so scary when you face the truth. Next, Yuk Swan decided to go to his father's old house to confess as well. He sold it because his father had invested in a project before he died, which turned out to be a bust and he got into debt, and later these debts fell on him and now he had to sell this house to pay off. The house is to be demolished, but he wanted them to visit it together one last time. Xu Yan remembers a box of candles for a cake. His mother used to make those candles as well as bake cakes herself. She was very sick, and when he was 7 years old, she passed away. His father started drinking, and sometimes he would beat him, and in the morning he would tearfully apologize and promise that it would not happen again, but it happened again and again. So when he grew up and moved away from him, and they didn't talk anymore. Corporate for the new New Year holiday, Xu Yan is left waiting for 5 minutes at the entrance. Yuk Swan said he would be right over. Olivia comes up and offers to take her to a place where it's fun. Xu Yan walks into the green maze and sees a bright glowing carousel with horses. Everything looks so beautiful and romantic, and she sees Yuxuan, who is so handsome, giving her flowers. Their life and work brought them together. She loved toys, and he became a designer of figurines, and he loved sweets, and she became a pastry chef. Yuxuan declares his love, gives her a ring, and wishes to be with her always and never part. Teddy and Olivia's wedding allowed them to meet again. He wanted her to know that their love was the most valuable gift in the world to him, and they decide to return home. Xu Yan goes out on the road, a car comes by, and Yuxuan covers her with himself. In the morning in the hospital, she finds out that he stood in front of the car to save her. Her mother takes care of her in the hospital, brings her cocoa and marshmallows, and Yuxuan once told her mother that when she feels bad, cocoa calms her down. Teddy comes to the hospital and says that these candles must be ruining time, but they are out of candles. Teddy confesses that Yuxuan was probably preparing to rescue her. He gave him the documents for the house he sold and information about his deposits to settle the debt problem when the time came. Xu Yan asks Teddy if he knows where the master who advised him on the story about the hero who goes back to the beginning but cannot change the ending lives. Xu Yan goes there and is greeted by an old woman who thinks she has the wrong address, but no, it turns out that it is now she who was living alone in old age. The woman explains the same thing, that most likely he just died instead of her, and anyway, at the end of the story, an accident happens and someone dies, and there is hardly any way to change a person's fate. Even if time goes back, the candle doesn't go back. When you light a candle, you have one day to fix everything, but they ran out of candles and everything remained as it was. Xu Yan is sure that not all the candles are out, that there is one candle left. She runs to Yuxuan's old parental house. It is about to be demolished. She risks her life, runs into the kitchen and finds another candle under the cabinet that has rolled there. The cabinet falls down next to it, but she runs out of the house in time, and everything collapses behind her. Then she lights the candle. Xu Yan believes that if he died instead of her, then there is a way to change everything. She makes a wish, if it will save Yuxuan's life, that they will never meet again and never fall in love. Time has gone back to 2018. Xu Yan wakes up in the morning to a phone call. It's Olivia calling her. Has she forgotten about the wedding? She and Teddy are waiting for her at the wedding. Xu Yan arrives at the celebration. There is one groomsman missing. Yuxuan was delayed by the plane and couldn't get to the wedding. Xu Yan looks for him at work, but he is not in the office. He and Teddy had a business meeting. She calls him, but his number doesn't exist in the network. Xu Yan stops looking for him and tries to continue living without him to avoid an accident in the future. She goes to Yuxuan's father, introduces herself as a person from the anti-fraud committee, and convinces him that he should not invest in the project in order to save Yuxuan from debt in the future. Xu Yan gets her mother's support and opens the bakery they dreamed of together. His co-workers wish him a happy birthday at a costume party in the style of Alice in Wonderland, and he is happy. One day, when Xu Yan is working in the bakery, Yuxuan comes in the door. They meet again. He asks if there is any more cake. Of course there is. He sees this goose that she once gave him for his birthday. They go outside and see the snow falling. They say that with the first snow comes those who love us, and those who are made for each other will definitely meet.